So individuals who carry mutations in what we now consider high-risk genes for breast cancer, such as BRCA1, BRCA2, and PALB2, should consider seeing a genetic counselor if they haven't already done so. Alternatively, they can discuss with their primary care provider their options, which should include chemoprevention, surveillance, as well as surgical prevention. When it comes to breast cancer risk, chemoprevention comes in the form of tamoxifen use. Tamoxifen is a drug that has been traditionally been given to breast cancer patients. However, studies have shown that taking tamoxifen prior to developing breast cancer can significantly reduce the risk of developing the disease. The second option for reducing breast cancer risk in BRCA mutation carriers includes increased surveillance. This increased surveillance should include a breast MRI on an annual basis, as well as a mammogram on an annual basis. Ideally, these should be interspersed every 6 months so that some type of imaging is performed on the breasts twice a year. Regarding prevention for breast cancer, currently the only option that we have is a bilateral prophylactic mastectomy with immediate reconstruction. These types of procedures are not easy to undergo from the psychological, emotional, and medical standpoint. And all of these discussions and decisions should be well considered and discussed with the healthcare provider involved in the patient's care. When it comes to ovarian cancer, the early detection is not as good as we have for breast cancer. Therefore, BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutation carriers should consider the option of ovarian cancer prevention once they've completed childbearing. Typically, this involves removing the ovaries and the tubes in a prophylactic bilateral salpingo-oophorectomy. Again, this is a decision that needs to be thoroughly vetted with the healthcare provider involved in the patient's care. Screening does exist for ovarian cancer, and it is in the form of a transvaginal ultrasound, ideally with color Doppler, accompanied by a CA125 blood test, both to be performed concomitantly every 6 months. Chemoprevention for ovarian cancer is actually the birth control pill. So studies have shown that individuals who take the birth control pill for 5 years or more uninterruptedly half their risk of ovarian cancer, whether they are mutation carriers or in the general population. So the birth control pill is a useful technique to reduce ovarian cancer risk in BRCA carriers. There are some studies that have shown there is an increased risk for breast cancer in individuals who take the birth control pill. However, most of those studies were done years ago, and the dosage for the birth control pill was much higher than currently available in our prescriptions. This risk should be definitely discussed with the healthcare provider involved in the patient's care. Ideally, a combination of any and all of those techniques should provide a patient with the best tools to reduce breast cancer risk and ovarian cancer risk, as well as prevent both of those diseases.
Do you know that not every breast cancer patient needs chemotherapy? Now there's a way to decide if chemotherapy will benefit you based on the unique biology of your tumor. To learn more about the Oncotype DX test and how to discuss it with your doctor, click this button.